Hello everybody, my name's Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build my Toggleable two-way minecart station. You can see here right in front of you. So as always, let's start with a little demonstration. As you can see here, we have a short T-junction with a minecart station basically in the middle. And I can decide where I want to send this minecart here, just by pressing one of those two buttons. And as you can see here, the minecart gets redirected into this minecart station like it's supposed to. But if I flick this lever here, I can still send it out wherever I want it. But now the minecart station is deactivated and I can do basically whatever I want. The minecart won't get into this minecart station, but will be just redirected further down your railway system. And of course, if I activate it again, the minecart will be redirected to the station again. So that's what this thing here is for. Now, how big is it? As you can see, the actual station is only 5 blocks wide, 3 blocks deep, and has a height of 5 blocks. So it's rather compact, seeing its actual use. And as you can see, there is not much that goes actually above the floor level, so it's also really flat in its visibility, which is also a plus. Okay, so now what will you need if you want to build this? Of course, you will need normal blocks. Then for the mechanism itself, you will need 6 redstone dust, 3 redstone torches, 1 redstone repeater, 1 normal piston, 3 sticky pistons, 1 redstone lamp, although it's optional. I would say it's a bit easier to see if the whole thing is on or off with the lamp. Then you will need 2 buttons and 1 lever to control this whole thing here, and 3 normal rails, 2 detector rails, and 1 powered rail. Additionally, you will need, of course, some minecarts, extra power rails, normal rails, and maybe some redstone blocks for the rest of your railway system. But anyway, that's basically what you need for this build here. So all that's left is showing you how to build this minecart station here. Okay, so start by placing your little T-junction, as you can see here. Then, at the middle part, place a powered rail. At the ends of your T, with a 3-wide gap in between, place your sensor rails, and then place first the 2 rails on either side, and then the 1 in the middle. And now, as you can see, this rail here connects with the right side. If you are building this and at this point it connects with the left side, you will have to mirror all that's following from this point on. But anyway, so now go down below the junction itself, place a block with a torch on top, then on either side place 2 blocks until you get this little W here, and then place some redstone on top of those blocks here. Next, go to the back of your whole build. Start by placing a block down here with a torch to the side and a repeater on top. Then, right besides this block with the sensor rail on top, place a non-sticky piston followed by a sticky piston. Block below the sticky piston. Then another sticky piston right besides this block, and with a 1-wide gap, another one here. Place normal blocks right in front of them. Make sure those are full blocks. Then place 3 blocks around like this to get this little cross shape here. Put down 2 redstone dust here and a torch there. Block on top of this redstone with a lever on top. Then you can place your redstone lamp to the side. Next, grab a few normal blocks, place one up there, another one on top of this non-sticky piston, and place your buttons towards the middle. Then another one a normal block up there. And that is basically all of the redstone parts of the mechanism itself, of the two-way minecart station itself. All that's left now is putting in the continuation of those rails here. And for practicability reasons, make sure you place a power drill right next to those sensor rails here, or otherwise you might get not to the next part of your rail system. But anyway, how this looks, I'll show you after a little cut. And done! So as you can see, I placed a few more rails down and also put in a few more blocks here to fill in the free spaces here. And that's basically how this should look now. So all that's left is giving it a little try. And as you can see here, it works just like it's supposed to. Okay. So, anyway, that was how you can build my Toggleable two-way minecart station. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and, well, see ya!